Anyway, for those who are familiar with it, this is apparently his response to what happened. So let's have a look-see.
Cringe moments. There were multiple woke moments that were obnoxious. God of War Ragnarok.
What a great. I'm just trying to get to a different section right now.
Ragnarok won way too many awards, but at the very least, Elden Ring won Game of the Year, so it's not like it was terrible. Now, normally I would end the video here, but as you may have heard, there was some recent controversy involving me. Apparently, for whatever reason, a podcast called EFAP that I know many of you have heard for whatever reason.
We already know what EFAP is.
You know,
yeah,
they mentioned
kind of
us
with the way that he mentions it. It's like, a podcast called EFAP. You know, like
what is that? A channel that is in my recommended, like my feeds.
Whose hosts I specifically call out by name, MauLer in particular.
Whose episodes I claimed to have declined since Wolf had left. Which, by the way, made people think, like, maybe you forgot what EFAP was. No, he's actually, because there's the thing, I was cursed to have watched all of his streams. He talks about some recent EFAP episodes in one of his streams. He talks about the Philosophy Tube one. He said he watched
it. Oh, yeah, that's so, right. Well, Destiny,
like,
that's right.
Right off the bat. Just trying to come across as the cool guy. I was like, what? What is this? What is this EFAP thing? I don't know.
What's that? And, I mean, also, I don't know all of the things about the hosts personally that I would make fun of.
We have a clip of you.
You specifically said that if you came on, you would say, you know what to make fun of each of us for. Whether it's Jay and the trans stuff, whether it's me and the not being straight. I'm sure with Fringy and Mahler, he has plenty to say. But come on, you can't try and be just a weaselly little liar, dude.
Yeah, weaselly.
When you know. Don't act like you don't know. Because
then, of course,
we know that you know. We
with
all know.
What he knows, why would he be like, why were they responding to my videos? Like, yes, EFAP's not known for responding to videos that have differing opinions or anything. That's not like what it was predicated on.
Especially not mine. I was...
There was the thinly veiled thing at the end of his, like, Ragnarok video. And then, yeah, on top of, like, all the times in stream when he was shitting on you. And a lot of people, actually.
Yep.
I would end the video here, but as you may have heard, there was some recent controversy involving me. Apparently, for whatever reason, a podcast called EFAP that I know many of you have heard of decided to make a video on my God of War Ragnarok review. Which, honestly, I don't really have a problem with. As I've said many times in previous videos, I don't script my reviews. Insecure. They aren't particularly
Stop it.
Yeah.
Stop doing the thing where you explain the reason why they're riddled with flaws.
Well, as opposed to trying to be better, as the game desperately tried to explain, like...
If you're going to do it a certain way, you need to own the fact that people are going to respond to the things that you said in that video, whether they're true or not. They don't care how hard you worked on it. They don't care what your methodology was. All they care about is whether the things you said were accurate or not. That's it.
And they were,
like,
almost exclusively not accurate. Well edited either, and that's very much on purpose. So I'm sure they could pick it to pieces if they... Exactly. Well, but it's on purpose. And he's the one who said, yeah, I know I get things wrong all the time and da-da-da-da-da, I'm not going to change it.
This is a line of logic to me. I make it in a way that results in many flaws, so, like, what's the deal, guys? Like, why would you respond to it almost by that's almost the implication, leave me alone.
I don't know, I feel like he's pretending as though there's not great, like... Well, we said it when we were covering his video. It's just like, if you're going to accept that your methodology results in significant errors, then you have to expect results that include people basically pointing out how wrong you are, right? That's like...
cares how you made it. Like, it's that simple. Nobody really cares, like, how you made it or how long you spent working on it. All they care about is what is apparent in the video. That's it.
Yeah.
As I've said many times in previous videos, I don't script my reviews. They aren't particularly well edited either, and that's very much on purpose. So I'm sure they could pick it to pieces if they really wanted to.
They could destroy it if they wanted to.
They could pick it to pieces if they really want to. Like, okay,
thanks, mate.
what is that even meant to mean? Like, I recognize that it is so deeply flawed that it could be torn apart.
Apparently.
Probably wouldn't be hard for even me to do that to my own videos. What? Then do it! Then do it! Then why aren't you doing it?
The process you're describing should take place before you hit publish.
Before the video's done, yeah.
The whole idea of that is that, like, us, we're supposed to be very good critics of ourselves. We have that running all the time, all the processes. Why are you, like, yeah, I could have ripped apart my own video if I wanted to. It's like, what? Why
you
would
should have done that in the editing process. That's part of making the good video.
And so I popped into the stream for about 10 minutes, and what did I discover? That MauLer had watched up to 20 hours of my God of War Ragnarok stream.
Yeah, but some of your viewers would have done that too, though, right? So do you,
yeah,
what are you implying?
You can already detect the tone. I'm being shamed for this, aren't I?
Yeah. How dare he watch my stuff? What a loser he is to watch my streams.
Isn't that really funny? Like, some of his audience surely watched his whole God of War Ragnarok live stream, sure, right?
That's kind of like the point of the audience.
Would he look at those people? Would he look at the audience and go, "Wow, you watched 20 hours"? You know what I mean? Like,
why he's constantly like, devaluing his own content, but not in the way that we do because his content's shit. It's that, like, I can't believe anyone would actually. Like, how terrible would it be? I got to be able to denigrate MauLer for watching my stuff, but I'm not going to think about what that says about my audience. That would be, kind of.
Well, I'm sure the framing is going to be that I'm obsessed or crazy or.
I guess it's kind of funny, though, right? It's like, you watched 20 hours of my live stream. It's like, yeah, and you played the game for 20 hours. Like, you know what I mean?
Like, it's such a, like, people, I guess, it's doing the motivation farming shit that I've always hated, but it's just like, if only they knew the truth, which is. I was watching his video and I was like, I wonder how he played the game. It tells me a lot about someone in terms of what they think of the game when I can see their entire playthrough. Oh, he streamed it. Well, I guess I could watch it while I'm sorting out like how I'm going to edit together his initial video and the future video so that, like, the whole reason that all happened the way that it did is that I didn't want to have us basically, like, you know, when he says, like, Odin offered a really great deal, he should have taken it. Then we do all the responses that he, even his fans, gave him, and then he responds to that in the later video. If I played the whole full video, then we'd have to repeat all of the topics as we come back to them in terms of the responses. I figured, why wouldn't I just do it one by one? That makes the most sense. And then, of course, if ever I found stream footage that completely countered his opinions on what was happening in the game, I couldn't help but put them in to be like, this guy's lying to you, by the way.
Oh, I popped into the stream for about 10 minutes, and what did I discover? That MauLer had watched up to 20 hours of my God of War Ragnarok streams and edited together a hit piece on me.
So, what's the difference between criticism and hit piece? Just let me know.
If it's just a description of the things that you do, if it's just your own clips, if that in and of itself is a hit piece, then that does say a lot about. You.
People would describe that as a cell phone, right? Like, if
that's a good way to describe it.
So yeah, I don't,
if you just think clips of you playing as a hit piece against you, okay, dude, interesting.
Yeah, pretty much. Like, you can call it a hit piece if you want, but it was work, and it was a response to how bad you are as a game reviewer, and then just highlights of how awful your personality is. If that's what a hit piece is, I guess the motivation. Could be like malicious, but it was just this is stuff that I found and wanted to show other people. It was all public.
Malicious or not, it's factual.
It's all from his stream. Really, so I understand, like, issue. What's the problem? You put this out there. Yeah.
You know, instead of actually spending that time making videos for.
So first of all, that is a video that I made.
That is a video. It was also. It's not only a video. You got to essentially double dip with it because, in and of itself, it is a very interesting. Observation on this character, this synthetic man guy. It's also the blueprint for a stream, which is our job.
This is a weird jab.
Wait, it's what he said.
Well,
he already said this in the
on the stream.
Yeah, you think YouTube videos don't last? They're just it's just dust in the wind.
The criticism of MauLer is that he doesn't make videos anymore, right? He's lazy and a fat, complacent, like just sitting on his pile of money that he does from this
little dragon, right? Chubby dragon.
It's kind of like. You're almost trying to simultaneously imply laziness while shitting on somebody for spending a lot of time on a task.
Yeah, exactly. He spent 20 hours. Isn't that crazy that he did all this work instead of doing all this different work?
Something that's really something that's good to do is to, like, sit with your thoughts and try to reconcile incompatibilities between thoughts that you hold.
He could even tear apart his stuff if he could be asked to, but he doesn't. He just wants to hit the algorithm.
And he's really but really, really annoyed that you did.
Sorry, I was watching you. I wanted to take you seriously. I wanted to see what arguments you had. I was told by many people you had the best Ragnarok criticisms. They were awful. Not the first time this has happened to us, though.
For his channel. I wish I was joking, but seriously, they didn't just watch my review and the response video.
MauLer was editing the stream to make you look bad.
I would love to actually have you explain how that's the case.
The problem is I couldn't edit it any other way. It was impossible with the clips I had. How do I make him look good? It's what he says. It's his opinions. They're awful. They were really bad. They were uninformed. They were contradictory. A lot of them were just lies. Also, he's foul. Like, what do you want to do with all that? I can't show his video in any format that makes him look good. Not my fault.
Yeah. What things were out of context?
Arguments that other people use for The Last Jedi and Rings of Power on them. Can you, like, sort of just... What is the deal? Like, why does everything have to be filtered through these weird lenses?
I've seen loads of this. Like, wow. So MauLer's using the same arguments that if you... So I've seen the one where it's like, do you remember the not-so-great debate where the guy said he's old? MauLer has used this as a defense of Kratos, that it's been a long time since the original trilogy. And I was like, wait, yeah, did they skip the part where I was like, that time was filled with development that we played through as the... Everyone forgets also, the end of God of War 3, man.
Exactly. I was about to say, the hugely important part is that God of War 3 kicks off the arc that he goes on in these two games.
He stabbed himself with a giant magical sword. I think...
The beginning of the change in the character, whereas what happened with Luke is that he was super-duper happy and then saved the day, and then we see nothing, and then he's a hermit, a pissed
miserable
off,
miserable asshole
hermit
who abandoned his family and the galaxy.
Yeah,
exactly. We didn't get any of that information, and it was a much shorter period of time as well.
Meanwhile, this Kratos, we got hours upon hours upon hours of all these like discussions and inspirations he's had from all these different people.
Yeah, and
events
we've got exactly and retrospective information with Faye, even in those few scenes, a little bit of insight into how that relationship would have fed into the arc that he goes on. It's not comparable.
This is like the tribalism shit, man. Like, if you dislike Last Jedi and Rings of Power, then you should dislike Ragnarok. The thing is, plenty of people are out there who are like, no, that's not how that works. I don't know if you saw it. One of the top comments I read was like, why is he saying if you're right wing, you should dislike Ragnarok? Like, I'm right wing and I do not like feel that way. I was reading stuff like that. I was just like, that's going to be weird, right? Like,
you're being gatekept on
your fundamental beliefs about life through a video game.
Because of a game that you like. Yeah.
It's fucking bizarre. But yeah, I mean... Sure, don't watch the coverage, just go from what one person said in a comment.
Oh, no, he edited
together...
But why isn't
he going by what the other people said in the comments, where they were, like, thoroughly impressed with the coverage terms of the thoroughness of it?
The stream clips weren't additional context, they were actually taken out of context. So, when he says, the enemies are spongy, and then I show clips of him saying he doesn't understand the mechanics, he doesn't use the moves that explicitly say they deal more damage, and he doesn't understand how to use certain moves because there's too many buttons. You understand that his criticism that the enemies are too spongy is worthless. It might be true.
Yeah, you're adding context.
Yeah, that is additional context. That tells you how he constructed this opinion.
How is it not additional? Like, it's categorically additional context. It explains a lot about the argument that he made in his video.
And then trying to bandwagon the puzzles, they're way too easy to solve, and they give you clues anyways, so it's pointless. Like, everyone pretty much agrees with the criticism, but then you see him solving the puzzles, and you're like, holy fuck, dude. People like you are why the devs made it this way.
Well, I thought we all agreed. I thought we all understood the problem with the Dean Takahashi, like, Cuphead thing.
I thought we did too.
Understood what that meant. Which, if we don't, the reason why it's really bad to see Dean Takahashi unable to complete the tutorial level in Cuphead is that if he made a review of that game, it'd be worthless to me. We're just not playing it the same way. We're not on the same level of play. So if you were to alternatively watch somebody who was able to play a game at a super high level of play, that they could play it on a really hard difficulty, pull off all of these crazy combos or something, you'd be able to, it's like, oh, you understand the game. You have, like, a greater understanding of the game. You probably have insights to offer that I wouldn't be able to pick up because I'm not as good at you at this. Like, if you're, like, incapable of even playing the game at a base level, anything you say about the game has to be filtered through the lens of, oh, but that was how you played it, which is not going to be the way that I played it. It's kind of the difficulty of like reviewing video games that you don't really have with something like a film or a television show, where like, I guess everybody has different levels of understanding about like the material in the story, but there's no like skill influencing, you know, somebody's perspective on the mechanics like there is in a video game. I thought we all understood like what the problem was there. I hope it wasn't just lol, he sucks at the game, haha. Like, I hope it wasn't that simple.
Oh, dude, I've seen people say, like, so EFAP are against sponsorships? And I was like, did you listen to anything we said? Like, anything at all?
No,
I'm pretty sure that we explicitly said, like, if you're going to take a sponsorship, take it from, like,
if it's a good sponsorship, it's good. If it's a bad sponsorship, it's bad.
You can take a sponsorship from Raid Shadow Legends, especially people who have no idea, like, have no interest or understanding of gaming as an industry, and they're just like, I don't know, it's a product, and it works. They don't know, like, the predatory nature of mobile gaming and stuff. But you can't have a guy who's like, I'm the real dude about video games, and everyone else is a sellout shill.
Left, man.
And then
you he shills for one of the like,
notoriously
Legends.
Terrible games ever. And then apparently in the following video is like, it's bad, by the way. Don't go get it.
Well, too late. You already recommended it to me, and I tried it, so.
Sponsorships are fine. I thought we all
they're
knew.
They're for good things that you vetted.
Well, I should say sponsorships are neutral. It's you need more information.
They're neutral. They're absolutely neutral. It depends on how you approach it, and especially how it slots into your broader statements and goals as a creator.
So, oh yeah, the other thing I was going to say as well, like just because that's like a gameplay example in the puzzles and the combat, but then also the story example, right? Where he was saying, like, he was talking about one of the better scenes of the game. He like complimented like two or three of them, but. He said, like, my initial grievances with this were Atreus was being condescending. And then I just showed, like, his actual commentary from that scene, where he was like, the characters are being assassinated!
Right,
like,
so
what?
I think, I'm glad you brought that up, because looking at that last sentence, the stream clips had no place being included because reviewers' actual thoughts after completing the game. It's like, now, it may well be the case, because, of course, like, the thing that you think first, ideally, if you're, like, you know, trying to be really thorough in creating a review, you might figure out things about a game or a story that are better or worse after you play through it. Your thoughts kind of coalesce, you get them organized. You know, there's something to be said, obviously, about, like a definitive statement on something after spending a lot of time thinking about it and working through those thoughts. But it's a little bit awkward when somebody says, I initially thought this in their final review, but then they said something totally different when they initially saw it. It's like, that doesn't... Well, you know,
he made a claim about what happened when he first consumed it that was just false, and that's the point of seeing that. It's like he's lying to you. He launders his opinions to be more acceptable. And remember, he's not going to put in the video, by the way, guys, I think you're part of the industry's problems if you listen to dialogue. Because that's a batshit insane take.
That is an insane thing to say. If you don't think it's insane, then you have an issue. You have a problem.
And by the way, like I remember seeing on his video as well, it's like, oh, so... They're complaining about you not taking it seriously, not listening to dialogue, and not like engaging with the game on its terms, and yet they did what they did with The Last of Us 2. And I'm just sitting there like, what, engaged with it on its terms? That's what I did.
We totally did. We were listening. Why do we think we were able to give it such a comprehensive breakdown? We listened. We paid attention. Well, so, yeah, that's how we knew it wasn't good.
That your references are accurate. Like,
oh, yeah.
The most important thing.
I guess that's something that we didn't make clear to people is that even if it's something that we think is probably going to be bad going in, we do listen to it. We give it its time of day.
That's how we know that it's good or not at the end. Because we're not always... Because obviously you can't base your opinions off of just what your first impressions or your desires will be. You have to actually check. Of course, only a fool would think otherwise.
Had time making videos for his channel. I wish I was joking, but seriously, they didn't just watch my review and the response video. No, he edited together a bunch of clips, put some of my points out of order, and showed many parts that had nothing to do with any of my points, but simply just...
I mean, he's technically true. I did throw some stuff in there that had nothing to do with the game.
Oh yeah, like when he was making fun of the Jewish conspiracy,
yeah,
and the undesirable, the obvious flaws of my sexuality, and things like that.
Yeah
just it's just things we noticed along the way. But
telling you,
even
when
then, I would say that those are related in some way.
Well, when you're working on a video where you're trying to discover the person's perspective on a lot of things, and then you randomly come across fucking calls to war and aggression against particular groups of people that are I was just like, holy fuck, I cannot believe this is actually happening. This doesn't even seem real. Oh, and that's another thing. We've been seeing that we've become cancel culture, and it's like, I haven't called for anything to happen to him.
Haven't said a thing.
And, I mean, I'm surprised that anyone didn't know this, but me, Fringy, and Rags are pretty liberal on free speech.
We're free speech extremists, almost. I think
you could call us that in reference to how the internet, like the Overton window of free speech. We're pretty extreme, yeah.
Yeah, these days, absolutely, yeah.
Just to mock in some way, and I was painted as some sort of neo-Nazi or racist.
I didn't paint you.
I can't imagine why.
I did not paint you that way. I played
your
opinion
that way with your words.
If people come away with that perspective from what you have said, that's a result of what you have said. Like, to be fair, this comment isn't even untrue. In the last 2 hours, MauLer showed stream clips portraying you as a homophobic, racist, transphobic, anti-Semitic. But that's not because I contextualized the comments and said that is the case. We played them. That was
those
it.
Those are the things you said. Yeah, those are the things you said many times over.
That account is Cobain. He was he's become known in the EFAP community as basically Synthetic Man's like sentinel. He was there for like the whole stream, apparently.
Or something. And he did all of this just because I disagreed with him about the quality of a video game.
Why don't you acknowledge all the clips where you were shitting on him, though?
He probably doesn't know that I know about him. Because he doesn't look into this at all. So if someone said, all right, MauLer, it's time to judge you. I'm in like a big old courtroom. They're like, tell us, what was your motivation to do this? Was it just because he said something about a game you like that you didn't like what he said? I'd be like, okay, do you really think that would be it? When EFAP's been going for this long, and we've covered so many people that completely disagree with us on something, why is it that, like, people have said the only other time it feels like MauLer has done this is with the Twitch React saga, but even that wasn't as extensive. So it's, and that was when someone was coming after a friend of mine. So it's like, so what is it? It's like, well, for anybody who watched the stream probably knows, around about the part where he, like, shits on all of my friends, me, and the work that we all do. And then he says that their sexuality is a character flaw. And then says some other really bizarre and crazy shit after basically lying about a video game that's pretty good.
Yep.
Basically, at this point, I'm like, well, what motivation don't I have? What is the golden motivation to have? And then do I not have that one? I think I have all of the motivations.
Something that I find interesting, because I think it's kind of like revealing, right, of the way that somebody else may think about all of this. There's usually like some broader objective, and like the goal broadly of basically like any episode of EFAP or any like coverage of a film or a video game or anything is to try and contribute to and improve the discussion surrounding media. That's like the goal ultimately. Yeah. It's to try and facilitate better discussions about storytelling. Yeah, media, video games, everything. There's like always that sort of working there to try and have better discussions, which it seems like it can never be that, right? It's like, oh, well, we're just talking about video games. Like, we're just talking about video games, or we're just talking about movies. Like, it can't be more than that.
Need to devalue what you're talking about.
Art is really important to me. Storytelling is like super duper duper important to me. And I want to facilitate and participate in like discussions about it for the sake of like not just, you know, entertainment, but to try and kind of have those better discussions about it, where we're trying to use references and sort of develop an understanding of people's frameworks, and to try and develop good frameworks that we can use. It's not just about, like, agreements or disagreements or, like, petty arguments on the internet about movies. It's kind of a lame way to view it, you know?
I just think that if it was as simple as you said something about a thing that I like that was mean, or vice versa, it's like, don't you think EFAP would be a very different show at that point? Like,
Yeah, you'd think so.
There's a lot of people who hate Ragnarok, by the way. Synthetic Man is one of many. So what was it? You know, like, surely it's more than that. And I would say, yeah.
And also, remember, it's more than just a video game to a lot of people. For the people who made it, it was several years of their life. And for a lot of people who played it, it's, like, a really important story that has deep meaning to them. And has, like, and has lessons that people are pulling from it that they want to try and apply to their lives that are, like, deeply important to them.
Well, how much the game means to them and how much they think it's getting shot. Well, funnily enough, that's kind of, I've said before, that was kind of the motivation behind me making the Soma videos was, it was tipped over the edge when I saw the Joseph Anderson video was having a big effect. And for all I know...
Right, where it's just like, I don't want to see that effect play out.
Yeah, that could have contributed significantly to the creation of Amnesia Rebirth, for all I know, which really fucking upsets me.
Right, and the destruction of further Somas from that studio.
Yes, no chance of getting another one sort of thing because of that, but... Yeah, so what I guess I'm saying is, yes, the pursuit of interesting discussions, the expectation that through more deliberate conversations we can perhaps push the needle slightly in terms of the overall discussion, to check out points of view that are completely alternative to ours, because, you know, coming away from Ragnarok saying, like he had several quotes from his streams, he was just saying, like, the story is just awful, and then in his video he said that the gameplay is, like, the best part, which I hadn't heard from really anybody. Most people I'd heard who didn't like the game shit on the gameplay quite a bit. So, like, okay, yeah, you got that. Then you got, like, he really has issues with me personally and with several of my friends personally to a aggressive degree. And to this day, I think he thinks that I don't know about that or that nobody knows about that. It's just like, it's in your stream, dude. I think he thinks of his streams as, like, a secret.
Yeah, it's weird. The way that he operates on a stream... And the way that he operates on his, like, normal videos, it's like a very, very toned down version of who he really is, so to speak. Because who you are in a live setting is arguably who you are in a more real sense.
This is kind of an interesting thought. Do you think that it's a bit more complicated than that, in the sense that the way that somebody, if somebody were to sit down, you know, like if... Like, there's instances where somebody says something, it's like, do you really think that? And they're like, nah, actually, no, I don't really think that. That's stupid. Like, if they're, as soon as they have a little bit more time to think it through, that, like, there's something to be said about a very well-thought-out, scripted statement on a topic or a video being somebody's essentially definitive thoughts.
I think it goes both ways, right? You could say something that is more honest that you wouldn't want people to hear because you're on a live setting, or you could say something that you genuinely don't believe that just seemed right at the time, and you're like,
"Yeah,
oh,
it
I don't
slipped
mean that.
Out." And then you exactly, it's it. Yeah, that would basically be my conclusion. But of course, it's in this case, it's a little bit more awkward, isn't it?
Well, one of the key factors, like, for people discovering whether or not what you said was what you believe is repeat offenses and what you do when you're
and
faced
what would
with
you
it.
Say yeah exactly if somebody says to you, do you agree with that thing you said? You got answers. There's answers to that question that are available to you that will be indicative of what you actually think at that point.
Yeah.
So the question is, am I going to respond? Fuck no.
Whoa,
I'm not
did.
Wasting 11.
I was going to say, this is a response.
This is a response.
And also, like, it's kind of funny to be like, ha ha, I'm not going to respond. I'm not wasting my time on that. It's like,
so,
yeah, when, okay.
when we finished the coverage, there was a question of, like, if he makes, like, a big old breakdown, are we going to respond to it? And we figured no, because there's so much shit we've got to do that it's probably not worth it. Mm-hmm. But the conversation also went to, like, he isn't going to do that. Like, in terms of, he's a pretty consistently written character, if I can be a little clowny with it. Like, he's what do we know about him? It's like, low effort, and very much doesn't want people to know about some of the shit that he says when he thinks he's got, like, a more core, more passionate audience listening. So it would be a very bad idea for him to do. Like, if I were a friend of his, I would not advise him to respond to it.
Yeah, I would say you need to zip your lip. You need to act as if this never happened. Carry on. Obviously, your audience is retarded, right? You need to just keep sailing on with that.
To be honest with you, I probably wouldn't have recommended this, even.
No, I do act as if you have no idea of it. You're totally ignorant of it. You've never seen it. Just let it go away.
And,
let it be forgotten.
Yeah, just it, and then if in live streams, people ask you about this horrible video that's been made about you. Just be like, you know, I've seen a lot of people have made responses. I haven't looked into them or whatever. Because this is the thing: when you've said stuff that he's said, less eyes the better.
Absolutely, the
I
less
mean, he
eyes
was explicit
better.
About
the
that himself.
Last thing you need is people watching.
So yeah, this makes sense.
7 hours of my life watching that shit. I don't give a shit what they called me.
Yeah,
the
you
fact
do.
That they couldn't just do a normal EFAP episode.
Hey,
I like
he
how
said he can't just do a normal EFAP.
Yeah.
Well, he
so
didn't know what EFAP was.
EFAP is. Yeah.
Also,
this is what we do, buddy.
That is that was a normal EFAP response. It's just like
people.
He's not aware that the Twitch saga.
EFAP.
They did. Dude, it's becoming people's like favorite episode of all time, which doesn't surprise me, I guess, because of...
Doesn't surprise me at all.
It is pretty funny that he would just say, a podcast named EFAP, but yet you can speak about the format so casually. It's just...
You know,
the
thing is, we normally do. Yeah.
We have done that format before. The Twitch saga was that format.
Yes.
Except Twitch streamers are actually aware that you will look at their streams. For some reason, YouTubers, I guess, or at least this guy, is like, what?
But also, you do care, because you made this response at the very least.
Yeah.
Code on my videos really says a lot about them. So I'm.
It says a lot about us.
What is it? No, like, tell me, what does it say about us? I'd be curious. Like, is it sad that we care? Is it sad that we defend our friends? Is it sad that we have the effort, that we care about art? That, what does it say about us, really? Or is it just sad, soy, pathetic, da 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 da, buzzword, buzzword?
I'm not going to give them the attention they so desperately crave.
You took that from me. Like, the whole point was that your attention whoring like crazy. You don't care about breaking down games properly. You just do it really quickly for whatever's coming out and whatever's popular. That's your whole thing. Because you're trying to get more numbers. You're trying to get more attention. You have the clips where you're clearly upset and jealous that the people who are above you right now don't agree with you on what is woke or not. And then remember when someone in his chat is like, why are you talking about MauLer so much? He's not even, like, who cares? He's not relevant. He was like, yes, he is. He's on several podcasts.
Like, well, yeah, it's a little bit, it's kind of funny, right? It's, again, the way that you talk about it on a stream is interesting, but then when it's the video, you hit a lot of the standard, like, points that are a lot more easily agreeable. Like, oh, yeah, they're attention-seeking. Oh, yeah, I don't care. Like, I've got better things to do in my life. Like, those sorts of easy... Mm-hmm. It's just funny. Because that's really, like, the easiest way to distill the difference between, like, his videos and his streams. His videos is, like, he filters through to make everything more palatable. But it's, like, not truly reflective of, like, how he feels. Or, like, what his actual perspectives are on a lot of things. Like, we saw examples of that in the coverage. It's really interesting as all, because it's so clear-cut.
And I suggest you do the same. This is the last I will ever mention this in a video.
No, it's not.
See you next time, guys.
That's
I bet guarantee you, I'm not going to watch him, but guarantee you he'll say it in streams. He'll be like, fuck the EFAP guy.
I think the fact that he very specifically said that, I think the fact that he said that, like, is indicative of the fact that he will talk about it in streams.
Well, he can't let
I mean, he couldn't help him. Well, he couldn't help himself when it was just shitting on you.
Of course.
Like, during his life, and lots of people too.
Like, it's funny because he's like, oh, you come after me, did all this just because I dislike it, I think differently of the quality to you. It's like, dude, we saw the clips where you're like getting angry every time any like cutscene plays. You'll just pause and then go, Bola likes this, by the way. Like, it upset you that I like it. It's fucking
You're
weird.
Clearly comparing yourself to Mahler. And in the same way that you are comparing yourself to many people, we could see it in your personality.
Well, do you remember the part where he was like very madly talking about Alana Pierce? And she works at Santa Monica, so I guess that might be an example of, right, somebody moving onwards and upwards and doing well in their career, and that seemed to piss him off.
Oh, quite a bit, yeah. He said he couldn't say what he wanted to happen to her because he'd get him banned.
Like, what is that, you know? Like, what are you doing?
That's a weird, yeah. Thing.
A little bit weird. So,
I guess that's the response there.
There you go. This is the thing, it's fine with us. Like, there's nothing for us to do. Yep. The video's there. Go watch it if you want.
Well, the coverage is done, yeah. That's it.
Yeah.